So we packed up and left Renmark this morning. We spent the weekend there and it was really nice. We were close to the Murray River, and we're just making our way now to Mungo National Park. So it's in New South Wales.
Dirt road.
And yep, we've just hit the dirt road. So I think it's about a 2 hour drive.
So we're going like the back of Renmark up into New South Wales. So instead of going through Mildura on the main highway, just because we're a bit unsure with what's happening with Victoria at the moment, because they're going into their 5 day lockdown, we don't want to get either stuck there or not get back to Queensland.
Yeah.
So we're going up through up over Renmark into Wentworth, New South Wales. Hold on, the road's closed.
It's a bit of a checkpoint thing for COVID. Bloody COVID. Sorry about that. We didn't have to do anything. We just drove straight past the checkpoint.
Yeah, like a little checkpoint just out of Renmark on this dirt road here.
Yeah.
And they're checking people coming from New South Wales, but didn't check us leaving, so I think we're all good.
Yeah, so basically we're going to Mungo National Park. We're going to see the walls of China. And we're going to do a little sunset sort of guided tour, and it goes for about 2.5 hours, and it lets you into it lets you into like secret parts of
like
the
sacred parts.
Yeah, like
so normally
restricted places. So normally, like when you go to see it, you can only go up to the gate, so you can only see so far.
It's like a little platform you can go look out.
Yeah.
Do like a self-guided tour on the main kind of dirt road, but on the tour you can actually go in and walk around,
and they tell you all the history.
They give you all the history facts and whatnot. So I think that's $65 per person for about 2 and a bit hours.
Yeah.
But it is Valentine's Day, so we thought we'd go do that as our little treat.
Yeah.
And I've heard it's like Mars.
And it's meant to be. What is it? It's like the oldest place.
Oldest place in Australia.
Yeah.
So I think they found like old Aboriginal sites and bones and all that.
Footprints.
Dating back hundreds and thousands of years. So yeah, they reckon it's the oldest place in Australia. So it should be pretty cool to go check out.
Yeah, and we'll try film as much as we can. I'm not sure. They might be a little bit strict because it is like...
Oh, I think you can... photographs and
you can photograph
that.
But I'll try film like when they're talking.
I'm not sure if we're going to be able to drone though. I think they
I don't think you're allowed to drone,
but,
so
anyway, we'll show you what we get up to. But yeah, it's about I think we're about 3 hours away,
and it's lovely dirt road. So
yeah, dirt roads have slowed down a bit too, so maybe a bit longer.
Everyone, so we made it to Mungo National Park.
Yeah, we're at the Mungo Lodge. Staying here, they've got a restaurant, campsites, cabins, and they do all the tours and that here, and it's like 2 minutes down the road from the national park.
Yeah.
We really came here because we have Diego.
Yeah.
And they're dog friendly here. Also because they do the tours here, so that helps.
Yeah, because they just leave.
They leave from here.
So, and we get back at like 9 o'clock at night or something like that, so we didn't want to go drive. But yeah, so we're doing our tour tonight. We're just about to head off. I'm really excited. Don't know really what to expect, but we'll show you guys. We're going on this massive like four drive truck bus thing.
Yeah, we'll film the little four drive bus.
Yeah, it looks really cool. But yeah, it should be good, and we're allowed to leave Diego just here in the van, so yeah, really good to stay here. And yeah, if you want to get a feed here or whatever, you can just in the lodge. So.
And here's our campsite. So that's just the car we've left it hooked up. Thank you.
ones that you see around you. These are more of those calcified trees that I was telling you about. The way these sand dunes would have originally been formed, it would have been the coastline, you know, 100,000 years ago, pretty close to here, hence why we've got all this white sand. And this westerly wind would have been blowing the sand, but then hit the tree line. The sand would then fall to the bottom of the tree, and then over thousands and thousands of years, would then build the sand up to create the dune. These trees are here, are rooted down in that red layer, as you can see through here, meaning they're at least 80 to 100,000 years old. When we started to see these ones come through, obviously they were whole. And then over the time, with the rain and the wind, pretty much just break them up pretty quickly, unfortunately.
Good all-terrains at the minimum, and make sure you got a spare, Now it's also quite remote out here. There's no fuel.
They do have reception though.
They do have recently, 2 months ago, they got reception, which they never used to. So we actually thought coming out here, we didn't have reception.
Yeah.
Now it's only kind of near the visitor center at the national park and at the Mungo Lodge and the main campground. But apart from that, traveling in and out and around the national park, I don't think there's any cell.
So we've just stopped here at Sandy Point Campers to have lunch. There's a massive lake down there, so we just took Diego for a run. We've just pulled up over here with the camper, and it's a really good spot. It's in Hay, and it's a free camp called Sandy Point Camping Reserve. We're not going to stop. We're just going to keep going, but it's a really nice place if you did want to stop for a free camp, and it's very beautiful around here. Okay guys, having a bit of Mexican tonight. We got our meat there, the little pockets. We got some veggies, cheese, salsa, and lettuce.
Alright, well it's a bit different today. Monique's having a little drive while we're still in the outback.
Yeah.
We stayed in a little town called Gulgawi, which is in between Hay and West Wyalong. So today we're driving east and then we'll go up north through Forbes Park, and we'll probably stop in Dubbo for the night. And yeah, a bit of a boring day, just driving really.
Yeah, we went and saw some silo art that was on the way, and it's basically just country fields out here, so it's nothing too interesting, but still a pretty drive at least.
And we've done Forbes Park and Dubbo in our previous
trip.
So we don't really need to stop and check it all out, them all out.
Yeah.
But once we go north of Dubbo, last time we went over to came from Tamworth. This time we're going up north to like Moree. So we'll check out those little towns when we go through there.
Yeah.
But yeah. Friday. Alright everyone, made into Grindawindi. We're back in Queensland now, the home state. Just filling up the tanks and dumped the toilet. And we're going to head over to Warwick, which is near my farm. And we'll be there for next few days. And then we are heading home on Sunday.